Coldplay are halfway through their Australian tour, and I got the chance to catch up with them this week.
Coldplay are the biggest band in the world. Their Grammy-winning Viva La Vida was the highest-selling album of 2008. Chris, Guy, Will and Jonny met at uni, formed the band, and have been best mates ever since. Over the next 12 years, the release of their single Yellow and the albums Parachutes, Rush of Blood to the Head and XandY solidified them as Brit rock royalty. Now, as well as advocating fair trade and throwing their weight behind the Sound Relief concert for Aussies in Need, the band is wowing crowds on their Viva La Vida world tour.
A special sound check for Rove.
Earlier this week, the good guys of rock and roll invited Rove backstage at their Melbourne show.
The new chat show look.
I don't know. Do you know what? Are you ready for this? I changed like three times before I came here. I wasn't happy and I changed and then out.
Just know it's like a date.
And that's what I ended up with. I know.
But this is a new look called Smart Casual.
That's it, isn't it? Great job last night. What number show are you up to now?
93.
We have a celebration for 100?
I thought we already did 100.
Did we?
We need to find out.
No. I was only a guess, really. I wasn't really interested. You find out because tonight might be the 100th show.
Does it get like that though, where you lose track of numbers and?
I think the thing you lose track of is the day of the week. I mean, weekends have no meaning, you know, because we do shows through the weekend, and so it's not like we have a break at the weekends.
So often we'll call our friends up and be like, "Hey, let's go out," and they'll be like, "But it's Tuesday."
And you're in Germany. Is your dad touring at the moment as
My
well?
My dad is very much on this tour.
How does he go living the soft rock lifestyle?
He's usually the last one out of the bar.
Yeah.
because he sort of fulfills the rock star side of things, you know?
And does he really have a problem with you swearing on stage?
Oh, 100%.
So have you seen Chris's dad tear strips off him at the end of a gig?
He doesn't get cross, really, just acts disappointed. Yes.
Now, obviously, there was a very long creative process putting this album together. You guys really pushed yourself harder than you probably have before. Would that be correct?
You know, we still can't believe we got our job, so we're just trying as hard as we can to keep it. So we try pretty hard on every record.
So do you put that pressure on yourself as well, as a group?
We got told if we made a shit album that you wouldn't speak to us.
That is true.
So, you know.
And here we are, so congratulations. Right. You live for now, Coldplay. So when you kick off a tour, do you still try to work out what's going to be successful and what isn't?
Yeah, completely. I mean, that's why we did our first 3 gigs for free, because we thought we couldn't possibly charge people for what might happen. Just because I'm losing,
doesn't mean I'm lost. Well, what do you look out for when you're on stage? What do you look out for to dictate the show is going well?
How many people are walking up the aisles going to the toilet?
Is that a fact?
Well, we thought yesterday, we came up with a method yesterday for if you wanted to, for the next time we get a tour together, we'll start and we'll employ a few people to do, like, bathroom counts. And so at the beginning of the tour, you know, because we probably won't be on that good form, we might get a high bathroom count through the show, and then we'll see how low we can bring it, you know, if we can make people desperate to go by the end.
I think your problem will be then when you go off for the encore.
Everyone will
you
go.
You come back out, empty arena.
It was just a little idea, and now it's gone.
Also, too, I should say, congratulations on being one of probably 10 bands that are the greatest band on earth, apparently.
Right.
So, how are you dealing with that?
We've never claimed that, have we?
No, you haven't, but...
Well, one day we claimed to be the greatest band in Perth. I think that's what you might be confusing.
That's massive.
And well, even that was only on
you
Sunday.
Along with the string of, you know, probably 5 to 10 other bands can be labelled as the greatest band on earth, and no one ever seems to have...
No, the biggest. I don't think anyone would say the greatest. What does big mean? I don't have any f***ing idea, but we are...
Well, orchestras would be big.
Exactly, they're bigger. We're one of the tallest bands in the world.
Yeah.
We definitely lay claim to that.
OK. Now, gentlemen, are you ready for your final five? I have one for each of you and then one for the group. Number five, Jonny, after all these years, do you have any clue what the song Yellow is actually about?
Bananas.
Number four, Chris, you were once voted world's sexiest vegetarian. What does it take to be a sexy vegetarian?
You really have to keep down on the old, you know, cattle slaughter.
What?
Keep that to a minimum. But I only held that title for a year.
And then who's had it since?
This is what I'm perplexed by.
Moby?
Maybe Moby.
Ah, there you go.
Maybe.
And number three, Guy, why was the band's first ever song called Ode to Deodorant?
Too sure.
Was it in reference to anyone in particular?
Perhaps
Will. Will was into sport, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Will is a lot of
things. What the hell is that
got to do with it? Not gone into washing.
I don't think it was.
The cracks are showing.
People in glass houses shouldn't throw stones.
Number two, Will, if you were all stuck in a blizzard, which one of you would be cannibalised first?
Well, that's a good question, actually. I'd probably go for John.
I'd like a
because he's the
nice
tallest.
Slice of Johnny.
So he'd provide the most nourishment and the most meals
there
for all of us.
Chris would break his vegetarianism for you. That's
would
very
actually,
sweet. Would that's
lose
very
or throw
sweet.
Away that title.
And number one for all of you, do you think you'd still be as successful if you'd stuck with your original name, Starfish?
I'm going to say no.
You're going to say no? What is the correct answer?
I don't know. See, because if you still wrote the incredible music you did but were called Starfish, would it make a difference?
What would happen if you were called Keith?
That doesn't work
so well, does it?
Yeah.
So, who will ever know?
We'll be back with more of Keith after this. Thank you, officially the tallest band in the world.
A title at last. Yeah, thanks, Rob.
Thank you very much.
Here's the album, Viva La Vida, and the tour of the same name is on as we speak. Go see it. Fantastic show. Tickets on sale now. We'll be back with Husey and Ben Lee.